Welcome back to Flock Talk. You guys requested it, so we are going to be doing part two for my favorite toy parts today. So starting us off, the first part I am using here is a banana leaf roll. These are so fun because there are many different levels to it. I find that birds, especially parrotlets and lovebirds, tend to really have this infatuation with layers, whether it's layers of fabric or like knots in string. The layers of material kind of woven into this little coil, they really love to chew and just like feel the different layers shifting between their beaks. So I just really love this toy part for that reason. Also for the fact that it has a really satisfying crunchy texture to it because it is just a dried banana leaf, and the extra little layers created by rolling up the leaf make it very easy to tuck and hide seeds into. Next up on the list is these bulk rolls of woven shredders. Now these are really great parts for birds that love satisfying crunches and love to create a lot of destruction very quickly. These tend to be really cheap to buy because you can buy them in these huge massive rolls for just a couple bucks, or you can buy them in thinner rolls as well. So it's nice and easy to quickly replace and throw them together. You can hang them up as is, or you can thread them on. They're very versatile. You could even hang them and use them as a perch for smaller birds to hang on to. But I just absolutely love these because it's a bunch of weaves. And if you guys know me, I love to put as much foraging as possible into my bird's activities. So anything that is this woven material with all these different layers and this braided sort of style, you can easily tuck seeds into and have them crunch away and find it. These styles of woven materials I find are really satisfying because they have such a good crunch. So when a bird goes ahead and starts chewing and crunching it, it's satisfying to them to hear that noise, and it's easy enough for them just to pick apart, break it, but because a lot of them are made out of banana leaf as well, it has sort of this rubberiness to it, so while it's crunchy and easy for them to break, it can actually be quite firm and a little bit tricky for those smaller birds to actually be able to properly break it off as easily as you would think it does. Third on the list is shredded paper. Now, I do buy shredded paper from bird-themed pet stores, but you can just stick a bunch of paper through a paper shredder or cut it and crinkle it yourself. I just find this more effective because it saves time for me, and it's not too expensive to buy a big old bag of shredded paper. Now, on its own, this does seem very boring and like most birds wouldn't like it. However, it makes foraging difficult. So if you have a basket or a pod or something that you have stuck treats into, a little bucket, and your bird is getting the treat out really easily, taking this paper and stuffing it in there so that way it's hiding the treat, they have to pull all this paper out before they can find the seed on the inside. And of course that creates a lot of mess, which is equally as exciting. If you remember some of the Halloween toys I got in October, a bunch of them did have that paper in it. There's one right above me here actually, but themed in different colors. And Newt has been destroying these. I have been coming into the bird room every day and having to pick all this paper up off the floor and re-stuff it into the toys. Even though there's nothing hidden in these, he finds a lot of joy in pulling the paper out of these toys and throwing it around. And big bulky pieces of paper are really easy to sweep up. It's not like tiny little wood chips that you can struggle with to try and pick out of the floor or that just keep sticking to things. Paper is really easy to sweep up and get rid of, so I find it helps the bird give the satisfaction of getting as much mess as possible out of their enjoyment, but being easy enough for me cleaning it up and not having a massive mess that is stuck in every little crevice and crack that it could possibly find. Of course, as with anything, if you have a bird that has a tendency to eat things that are not food, paper may not be the best choice for them. While most birds will just crunch a little piece off, roll it around in the beak for a little bit, and spit it out, some birds may ingest it. And paper in itself, if they have just a little bit, is not harmful. It will just digest and come out, whatever. But if your bird is gonna sit there and try to eat entire pieces of paper, they could cause harm to themselves. So of course, use your own discretion. If you think your bird is going to be damaged by paper, don't use it with them. However, if you have a bird that doesn't eat inedible things and you're supervising them pretty frequently and you know their tendencies, they're just gonna throw it around, there's no problems with using paper with your bird at all. Next is maybe the most overlooked aspect of a toy, but that is the pear hooks. Now, this is the most common style of hook you will see on any toy, and oddly enough, I find them very difficult to locate in hardware stores. Like, obviously, the stores must get these from somewhere, and it is a piece of stainless steel hardware. I should be able to find it in Rona for pretty cheap, but I can't, and I don't know why. So I do have to order these off of bird-specific websites. I suppose I could look and see if there's a hardware store online, but usually I'm ordering toy parts anyways, I might as well order a couple of hooks. But if you are ever throwing away old toys that your bird has destroyed, hang on to the hooks, because man, they get old, you need to replace them. It doesn't hurt to keep them. These hooks are great because there are a lot of hooks that are actually quite harmful for birds. There's ones that kind of pinch shut that can catch on their beaks. There's ones that the birds can unscrew and swallow tiny parts for. So you do need to be cautious of what you're actually using to hang up your toys. If you're like me and just make your own, you can always just tie a little loop and just tie it straight onto the bars of your cage or off of the ropes, whatever you've got. But for the ease of rotating toys around, picking something up, putting it somewhere else, and keeping rotation going pretty frequently, these hooks are so helpful, at least for smaller birds. If you have a larger bird, they will have a tendency to kind of play with these things in their tongues and unscrew it, which is fine because this little bit at the bottom that actually screws on can't really come off. Maybe if I were to like twist it and bend it, but my birds are too small to actually be able to do that with this particular piece of hardware. If you had a bird that does do that though, I would consider that a bit of a hazard. For larger birds, there are ones that lock, so you can screw it all the way up and lock it shut. There are a lot of different styles of hooks that you can use for birds that are a little bit more crafty when it comes to their hardware. But for most small birds, anything from your smaller conures and cockatiels down to your budgies, your canaries, your finches, everything like that, a tiny little pear hook does just fine. There's nothing sharp on it. It's all stainless steel. It is oh so helpful and oh so secure and makes rotation of their toys so easy. One thing to look out for with any piece of stainless steel hardware is rust when your birds are playing with it, or there's moisture that's getting on it, or just the natural wear and tear of time. You may notice that especially around the hinge and the screw portion, the hook may begin to rust. So you do need to make sure you are analyzing your toys, giving them a good rundown and replacing parts if you notice anything like that happening. The last thing on my list today, I actually don't have any left of, so I guess I'm gonna have to do an order maybe during the new year or something. I'll go and do a big bulk toy part order again. But it was twig bundles. Now, the first time I got one of these, it was kind of on a whim because I thought, you know, birds really like the varied textures in between their beaks. They like the layers. Maybe they'd like a twig bundle. And so I had bought it when ZB was still around. And oh my gosh, this tiny little bird destroyed these twig bundles. They come in all sorts of different sizes. You can get them just like an inch, inch and a half wide, up to like, I believe 4 inches. So they come in a lot of varied sizes for all sorts of different types of birds. And all it is exactly what it sounds like. It is a bunch of twigs with string wrapped on either side. And again, this is really, really easy for toys because you can hide treats in between the bundles. It has a bunch of different texture. And of course they're tiny, tiny twigs. So they have a satisfying snap when the bird crunches them. Additionally, if your bird destroys this and throws all the twigs on the ground, it is very easy to bundle them all back up, tie your own string around the end, and reuse that part over and over and over again. So it's a very easy multi-purpose toy part that you can just keep reusing. The other reason I really, really love toy part bundles is because I struggle with drilling holes in wood, in toy parts, in vine traps, in anything. I have so much difficulty with threading thread through things and making my own holes. So when I've got a twig bundle, I can just stick a pair of scissors through it, twist it to create that bit of a space, and just thread the string right through. I don't need to use hardware tools. I don't need to use anything other than a pair of scissors and some string, which makes toy making a lot more enjoyable for me because I struggle a lot with very basic things. That will do it for some of my favorite toy parts, number 2. There is probably going to be a number three because I'm going to have to order some new toy parts soon. So I'm going to go ahead and take a look, maybe order from a couple different shops, give them a try, and we will see what happens. So come the new year, I'm probably going to start looking into placing another big toy part order. There will very likely be an unboxing video of this, and then favorite toy parts will come to follow as the birds experiment. I'm just gonna take a look around, try a few new shops, and see if there's some things I haven't tried before that my birds might like, and kind of do a big experiment, try a bunch of new things. It's been a little while since I've done a toy part order. I tend to order way more than I need, so it will last for an exceptionally long time. And of course, I like to reuse as much as I can. Parrots and pets in general can be quite expensive, so anytime something breaks, I like to keep as many pieces as I can, make a new toy out of it, and just keep reusing until the parts are all depleted. So look forward to that. I will be posting over on the Instagram when I do finally order new things and when the boxes come in. So keep an eye out for those teasers, and I will see you all then. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you all next time. Bye. I am 97% positive this is the exact same shirt I was wearing in the last one.